Good evening. I want to welcome you to the telecast. My name is Kathy Ellis, and the name of this ministry is God's Power Surge, GPS for short, because I believe everyone needs direction and where they're going, and Jesus Christ is that direction. We're going to be talking about responsibility this evening and what that means to be responsible. And I want to sing some songs for you this evening, and this is an old one. Sing it with me. It's Come and Dine, because we all have a responsibility to come and dine if we so choose. Hallelujah. Jesus has a table spread where the saints of God are fed. He invites his chosen people, come and dine. With his manna he doth feed and supplies our every need. Oh, 'tis sweet to sup with Jesus all the time. Come and dine, the master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. He who fed the multitude turned the water into wine. To the hungry calleth now, come and dine. The disciples came to land, thus obeying Christ's command. Unto them, come and dine. There they found their heart's desire, bread and fish upon the fire. Thus he satisfies the hungry every time. Are you hungry? Come and dine. The master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. Soon the Lamb will take his bride to be ever at his side. All the host of heaven will assembled be. Oh, 'twill be a glorious sight, all the saints in spotless white. And with Jesus we will feast eternally. Come and dine, the master calleth, come and dine. You may feast at Jesus' table all the time. Table all the time. He who fed the multitude turned the water into wine. To the hungry calleth now, come and dine. To the hungry calleth now, come and dine. He's calling out to the hungry, saying, come and dine. And it's all of our responsibility, whether we do it or not. Because we can only control ourselves. We can only control this person. We can't control what other people do, what other people think, what other people want. We can't control that. And when we stand before God Almighty, we're going to be standing there by ourselves, and we're going to have to speak of what we have done and what we haven't done. It's our responsibility. It's our responsibility as a Christian to heed the word of God. Means when you heed to something, you take hold of it, you follow it, you observe it. It means you do as it has said when you heed to something. I want to sing another song, A Soul Winner for Jesus, because that's what we're all called to be, soul winners for Jesus. I want to be a soul winner for Jesus every day. He does so much for me. I want to aid the lost sinner to leave his erring way and be from bondage free. A soul winner for Jesus. A soul winner for Jesus. Oh, let me be each day. A soul winner for Jesus. A soul for Jesus. He's done so much for me. I want to be a soul winner and bring the lost to Christ, that they His grace may know. I want to live for Christ ever and do His blessed will, because He loves me so. A soul winner for Jesus. A soul winner for Jesus. Oh, let me be each day. A soul winner for Jesus. A soul winner for Jesus. He does so much for me. I want to be a soul winner till Jesus calls for me to lay my burdens down. I want to hear Him say, servant, you've gathered many sheaves, receive a starry crown. A soul winner for Jesus. A soul winner for Jesus. Oh, let me be each day a soul winner for Jesus. A soul winner for Jesus. He does so much for me. And He continues to do so much for me. You know, it's amazing what God has done in my life just here recently. I used to tease my grandson all the time about telling the mail lady, because he would always run out and talk to her and get the mail, and she'd give him a stick of gum. That was before he started school. And I said, you tell her that Mama wants checks, not bills. Just joking. And, this past week I did that. I got checks. And I couldn't figure out what in the world was going on, so I called. And they said, well, your student loans have been paid in full. And those checks are from overpayment. And I was like, well, praise the Lord. You know, and I had been praying for that because, you know, a lot of these programs, you know, they didn't want to take the full time that I had paid, but they had done some looking, and they did. They accepted the time that I had paid, and they gave me money back. Because every time they'd call and say, you know, your student loans could be forgiven, I said, from their lips to God's ears. God, they're saying it, that's what I want. He is such an awesome God. I was never... You know, I know God can do anything, but I'm still at awe at what He's done for me. Praise God. Hallelujah. And, I take my responsibilities very seriously. I pay my bills, and I go to work so I can pay my bills. And, I go to the church when it's open, and I worship and praise God, and I lead to praise and worship, or I assist in that anyway, and I take my work very seriously, whether it is for my job or for what God has me to do. And that's what we need to do. We need to take it very seriously, and we need to be very faithful in what we do. You know, sometimes we get to where we can't be everywhere we want to be. But I always say, God, work out my schedule. You know, this is your work. You work out my schedule and have me be where I'm supposed to be. And He surely does. And I thank Him for that. Because it's only by Him. I don't claim anything but Jesus Christ crucified and what He's done in me. Hallelujah. That's my testimony and how He saved my soul and how He continues to work in me because I praise and worship Him, the one true God. Hallelujah. I want to be a worker. And listen to the words of this song, because We're all supposed to be workers. We were all given that Great Commission, and that's what we're going to be talking about this evening with responsibility. And what a lot of people have not taken very seriously, and they've kind of shied back from taking any responsibilities, especially in church. But it is our responsibility, you know, as Christians, for the Great Commission. Hallelujah. I want to be a worker for the Lord. I want to love and trust His holy word. I want to sing and pray and be busy every day in the kingdom of the Lord. I will work, I will pray in a vineyard. Kingdom of the Lord. I will work, I will pray in a vineyard, in a vineyard of the Lord. I will work, I will pray, I will labor every day in a vineyard of the Lord. I want to be a worker strong and brave. I want to trust in Jesus' power to save. All who will truly come shall find a happy home in the kingdom of the Lord. I will work, I will pray in a vineyard, in a vineyard of the Lord. I will work, I will pray, I will labor every day in a vineyard of the Lord. I want to be a worker, help me, Lord, to lead the lost and erring to Thy word that points to joys on high, where the pleasures never die in the kingdom of the Lord. I will work, I will pray in a vineyard, in a vineyard of the Lord. I will work, I will pray, I will labor every day in a vineyard of the Lord. And you know, the Lord won't have you doing anything that He hasn't prepared a way for. All you have to do is take that first step, and you'll see. You know, if the Israelite children would have taken that first step across Jordan into the Promised Land, it would have been a whole different story. It would have been a whole different story. They wouldn't have had to have wandered for 40 years to wait for a whole generation of rebellious and disobedient people to die. It'd have been a whole different story. What kind of story are you writing for your life that you're shying away from, that you're afraid to step up and be a leader? Be a leader. You know, God has called us to fields of harvest. Said the harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. So many people are shying back from the labor because they don't feel that they are capable of doing what God has them to do. But it's not you doing it. All you have to do is say, God, here we go. This is, if you want to do this, then amaze me. Take that first step, and let me tell you, He'll amaze you. You'll be shocked and surprised at what He has you doing. And you'll have that joy and that spring just springing up and overflowing in you. It's like, wow, look what he's doing in me. Hallelujah. You'll never be the same. Hallelujah. You'll have a boldness and a joy and a peace. I'm not going to say it's not going to be hard at times, but he will lead and guide you in all truth and righteousness. His word says so, because he loves us. Now let's go to the word. We're talking about responsibility this evening, and we see in this day and age that many people are not wanting to be responsible for pretty much anything. Not holding down jobs, not taking care of their families, and it just goes on and on. And if they do have a job, they do as little as possible just to make a paycheck. And then even in the church houses, we see people not wanting to step up to teach Sunday schools or sing. Or testify or do anything much for the Lord. They don't want to take responsibility, and they shy away in fear. But we know that fear isn't of God, and he wants us to be bold and stand up boldly in what we believe in and what we do for the Lord, and take pride in it, not be prideful. But, you know, take the responsibility to do the things and to do them right, you know. And it's not our work anyway. It's the Lord's work. And he will definitely help us out in all manners of things and show us how to do things and teach us how to do things. Now, I never thought in a million years I would be taping telecasts. I was content going into nursing homes and everything, and I come over to Earl's program a time or two, and I'm on there still sometimes, and the Lord laid it on my heart to do this, and it just so happened that I started this right before COVID hit, to where I couldn't any longer go into the nursing homes, and that grieves me that I still haven't been able to get in there to encourage those folks, because I really enjoyed that ministry, going in and singing to them folks and sharing the Word of God and prayer with them and all. But, you know, I took my responsibility seriously. And even when I would go to nursing homes and there wouldn't be anyone out to listen or anything, or they would, you know, very few would come out, I still went, you know, because I take that very seriously, you know, take the ministry out. It doesn't matter the number. And I never did look at the number. You know, I've went into churches where it'd just be me and another fella, and we would sing and rejoice and pray for people. And, you know, things happened. You know, he would call me with praise reports from what we had prayed about. You know, so don't look at the numbers. And don't forsake the assembly because of the numbers. I know a lot of the churches quit having Sunday night services because attendance was poor. But I tell you what, you know, don't pay no attention to the number. There is always a steadfast few, amen? And, you know, we as Christians need to step up, and when the church doors is open, we need to be there when all possible. Now, I understand there's work. I know that all too well. And sometimes a body gets tired. But I have learned that when this body is tired and it's really fighting against going, that's usually when you're really going to hate missing that particular service. Because I tell you, you just never know what the Lord's going to be doing next. Hallelujah. But we're going to talk about responsibility. And the definition of responsibility is a moral, legal, or mental accountability. Reliability, trustworthiness. People don't want to get involved. Now, that's what we see these days. People don't want to get involved, whether they're too afraid of making mistakes, or they don't want to put the effort out for anything or anyone other than their self. We see a lot of selfishness in this world today. They don't do anything that doesn't benefit them directly. And what we don't understand is that when we serve the Lord, it does benefit us directly. Our spiritual man is going to live on forever. And when we do the work of the Lord, that's what we're feeding. We're feeding that spiritual man, and we're boosting up our faith, you know, doing the Lord's work. Because when you go out and do the Lord's work, you're going to see some things. I'm here to tell you some wonderful things that He does. I went out to a nursing home, and I prayed for this little lady. I had seen her and met the family, and then she took a turn for the worst, and they had her from a wheelchair into a Jerry chair. If you're familiar with any of the equipment, it's just like a recliner on wheels, mainly a Jerry chair. And she was in bad shape. You know, she wouldn't even talk to you. And the family had told me that her last heart's desire was to go home and to be at home for a few hours, because she lived close to the nursing home, and they really wanted to be able to do that. I prayed with the family in agreement that, you know, she would improve and have the desires of her heart. And let me tell you, this was on a Thursday night. Well, on a Monday afternoon, I had a friend of mine that couldn't make it for her time and asked me if I could go up and take that time for her at the nursing home. So I stepped in and did, and went up there at Monday afternoon after that Thursday we had prayed. And I seen them wheel her in, and she looked absolutely wonderful. I was like, well, praise the Lord. And I just couldn't wait for that service, because I wanted to go over and talk to her. And she looked so great and sounded so good. And she said, I got to go home yesterday. She had got to go home on that Sunday after we prayed Thursday night. Praise God. He is awesome. He is awesome. And He knew the desires of her heart, and she was a born-again Christian, and let me tell you, He let her have that desire of her heart, and she was able to go home several times before He called her to her eternal home. Hallelujah. And it just thrills my heart to be able to agree with the family and pray for her and see God move in that awesome way. So don't be afraid to step out and pray for people and have that boldness to do the Lord's work. You know, the Bible says, be ye first partakers. You know, He was telling me that at a prayer meeting. We have prayer meetings every Wednesday night, and He's there this particular night, and we were all praying. And I kept hearing Him say, be ye first partakers. Be ye first partakers. And I was like, Lord, what do you mean? But what that means is we partake of things of the world when we are in the world. When we're in church and when we're doing God's work, we need to be first partakers. If God gives you a word to speak out, you need to partake of that word that He's having you speak out. You know, whatever comes out of that pulpit is for the person speaking as much as it is for the people in the congregation. Amen? You know, and if He gives you a word of wisdom to give to somebody, you know, we have to be first partakers of that word, whether it's a word of correction or whatever it is. You know, we need to really look inward at ourselves and make sure that we're lining up to the word of God, because He doesn't give you anything to speak that isn't His word. Hallelujah. And that's what we're getting to. We'll get to the word. All right. We're going to talk about Mark chapter 16, verse 15, and we're going to talk about the Great Commission. And it says, and He said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Doesn't matter. Every creature. You know, I knew this brother who talked about when he first got called to the ministry, everyone thought he was too young and wouldn't let him preach in the church. So he went out in the woods and he preached to the trees and the stumps and the animals. And, and let me tell you, he is still on fire for God today. Oh, hallelujah. Blesses my heart to see him minister. And he is truly a man of God that is on fire. And I love to see people on fire for God and have that zeal for Him, you know, that love to just go forth and do with all that's in you, to have that passion to work for God. Hallelujah. And we're all supposed to be that way. He told the 12 that was standing there, were the 11 that was standing there, to go into all the world and preach the gospel. And what they did is they preached the gospel and made more disciples. And we are disciples today. So this word is for us today. Go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Hallelujah. And Matthew 28, 18 through 20, and it says, And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, All power is given unto me in heaven and earth. He was letting them know that all power was given to him. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen. So there's no need to worry when you go out and step out and do what God has called you to do, because Jesus is there with you. And all you have to be is faithful to take that first step, and He will take care of the rest. He will open doors, and He will bring people into your life to help you, and He will provide finances if you need that. I'm here to tell you, folks, God can do and will do that for you, just like He's done it for me. He's done it for me. So I know He'll do it for you. He's no respecter of person. Hallelujah. And He is wanting people to go out into the harvest fields. And He is, because the fields are white with harvest, but the laborers are few. And He's wanting us all to be laborers. He's wanting us all to go from beyond the church house out to wherever we live, wherever we work, wherever we go, that we should be on fire for God. And when He says, go speak to that one over there, all you have to do is walk over there and He will give you the words that come out of your mouth. He'll do that for you. You just have to be a willing vessel and step back and say, whoa. That was awesome. Galatians 6:5 says, For every man shall bear his own burden. Every man shall bear his own burden. We have a responsibility in this life, and we're to bear it. Each one of us has a work to do. Each one of us has a walk with Christ, and we are to share that burden. We are to bear that burden, and He will share it with us, and He will help us with it. He says, take up thy cross and follow me, because it's not going to always be an easy walk. It wasn't for Him. He was persecuted, and He was mocked and ridiculed, and religious leaders, the church folk, hello, the church folk was after Him. And sometimes when God gives you a word or wants you to do something, when you tell the church folk, they might say, oh, now I don't believe He. You go forward with what God has spoke to you. Don't let people talk you out of it. If you heard God tell you that, go forward in it. And don't be afraid, because it's your responsibility. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 3:8 says, Now he that planteth, and he that watereth are one, and every man shall receive his own award according to his own labor. Our reward in heaven is going to be determined by our labor down here, what we have done for the body of Christ, what we have done for the upbuilding of the kingdom of God. It is our responsibility, and we need to take it seriously. And don't be afraid. If God spoke to you to teach Sunday school, well then, get up and teach Sunday school. It actually helps you learn more about the Word of God teaching. You know, and it's an awesome way to learn, and it's an awesome way to grow and get boldness that you need. Hallelujah. Because every step you take and everything that you do for the kingdom will build you up in your faith and your journey. Now let us pray. Lord God, as we have been encouraged this evening to take on our responsibilities and to take them seriously, because it's a wonderful and joyous work that you have us do. Lord God, let us not forsake the assembly. Let us not forsake one another and help each other out as you have you bring people in to help us, Lord God, and as you are always with us to comfort us and to light the way. You said that you will be a lamp unto our feet and a light to our path, and you will guide us in all truth and righteousness. And Lord, we can hold on to those promises that you give us, that we are never left alone to do your work. You are always there with us, and it is such a joy. And Lord, if there's one that doesn't know what they're to do, Lord, reveal it unto them, Father God. Let them have a hunger and a thirst to ask you and to spend time with you to get the instructions that they need. And if there's one that needs salvation, Lord God, save their heart, soul, Lord God, their eternal soul for eternal life. For their eternal life. Lord, if there's one sick, Lord God, touch their body, Father God, and give them that healing balm, Lord God, that only you can do, and manifest it in them, Lord God, to where they can be raised up out of that sickness. And we ask this all in Jesus' name. And my time is up. And until next time, I hope that you are blessed.